Hi, I'm Megan, and I'm an intern with the Naturalist Center at the North Carolina Museum of Natural Sciences. Today, I'm going to introduce you to one of North Carolina's native pollinators, the leafcutter bee.
They belong to the family Megachilidae and genus Megachila. With about 242 species of leafcutter bees, you can find them all over North Carolina and just about every other continent other than Antarctica. Leafcutter bees are the size of a honeybee, but they are mostly black with white setae on the abdomen called scopa. They transport pollen by packing it into the scopa. The males tend to be smaller than the females, and they have hairy faces and blunt abdomens. Only the females have stingers, and they are mild in comparison to honeybee or wasp stings. They differ from other more well-known bees because they are solitary. This means that they do not produce colonies or live in hives. Instead, the females construct nests. In family Megachilidae, the females create their nests in narrow cavities made up of pieces of leaves and petals that they cut with their jaws. There is a lot that is put into the creation of these nests. The females will mate with a male during the summer, and then she will begin to construct her nest. She will find a hollow cavity in rotting wood, hollow stems, or even holes in man-made objects, like concrete walls, where she will lay her eggs. Once a suitable cavity has been found, the bee will cut pieces out of leaves and petals found on foliage, and she will create about 10 to 20 cells out of them within the cavity. Then she creates a pollen ball made out of pollen and nectar to go in each cell for feeding. After completing this for every cell, she lays one egg per cell. They are then capped off with a round-shaped leaf cutting. The bee will be able to control the sex of her offspring by withholding sperm from certain eggs. The split is usually 66% males and 33% females. The males hatch first, so the mother bee will place the female eggs in the spots behind the males. The eggs will remain in their cells through the winter and emerge in the spring as adults by chewing through the nest. Their life cycle within the nest is interesting because it lasts so long. They grow as larvae until they are able to spin a cocoon made of saliva. They will emerge from the cocoon as adults, eventually emerging from the cell. Then the whole cycle begins again. Leafcutter bees are an important pollinator in North Carolina and all over the world. They are able to pollinate certain plants more efficiently than other bees, such as fruit trees and alfalfa. With the decline of honeybees and other pollinators, leafcutter bees are becoming increasingly important for every ecosystem they inhabit. The two most common species of leafcutter bees you will find in North Carolina are Megachila brevis and Megachila mendica. A species of leafcutter bee that is not native to North Carolina is the Megachila rotundata. This species was introduced here with the purpose to pollinate alfalfa crops. If you want to help these bees maintain a healthy population, you can create a bee hotel. You could make your own by getting an untreated block of wood and drilling holes in it about 5/16 of an inch in diameter. Don't drill the holes all the way through the wood, though. Provide routine maintenance and a roof to keep rain out, and you'll have a hotel for leafcutter bees. Another way to help them is by planting flowers and foliage native to North Carolina, and by avoiding pesticides as they harm many of our native pollinators.
Leafcutter bees are an important part of our ecosystem, and hopefully I've inspired you to help protect them. If you'd like to learn more, visit the links that I've posted in the description. Thanks for watching!